Biology is in every part of the world we live in and contributes in so many ways, whether that's to having clean water, whether it's food security and overcoming hunger, or whether it's sustainable cities, you know, or human health. All those areas have biology at the heart of them. And it's more than that, much more than that, because I think the way in which geopolitics have evolved has meant that science is contributing more and more to solving global challenges. And if you look at something like the UN sustainability goals, you know, of the 17, I would say at least 15 have biology contributing to delivery of those goals. I don't think you can overplay the importance and the urgency with which we need to act. People will often say, you know, why should I worry about biodiversity? Why should I worry that there are fewer dragonflies or ants or butterflies or whatever it might be? Why does that really matter? Actually, 75% of the crops that we eat rely on pollinators. They rely on insects to come and do that. Without those crops, we don't have sustainable food for either ourselves or for the animals we might consume, if we're consuming animals as well. And that's happening now. It's not about somewhere else. It's about the here and now. And if we don't get some of these things right, I think it could be quite devastating. Well, I think we have to have the right funding structures, obviously, but perhaps more importantly alongside that, there needs to be a regulatory framework which supports ethical innovation and allows organisations, individuals to realise the potential of their ideas and concepts and in their works. And fundamentally, it's about ensuring there's a partnership between policymakers, between government, between learned societies, between individual biologists that says, you know, we are all in this together and actually we have to work collectively to resolve the issues. I think building a culture of trust is really important. I think for there to be more trust, there has to be an explanation of the value of what you do and to show real life examples of how it makes a difference. And I think if you can do that, you can bring people with you and show them the opportunities. So I think I would say to biologists, you know, tell your story. You know, tell people about what you do, why you do it, you know, why it's important, the difference it will make. We have to bring the public along as part of this dialogue. If we don't do that, we can't expect public funds to be used in the way to support this type of work if people don't recognise the value of it. So I would say to them, you know, first of all, do that, go out and communicate and make communication of your science just as important as the science itself. And I think if we could get those things working together, there will be a greater understanding and actually a much more willingness in civil society to invest in a way which makes sure we can be much more sustainable in the future by using those resources much more effectively.